No, yeah, and oftentimes, well,
No, it's a good question.
The final agreement will say what the payout schedule is, so you pay on a monthly basis on progress to that point. You know, I was, you know, you could have gone into, you know, like an hourly billing rate or something, but, you know, and that's why I thought if we're going to separate out an interim, but we chose not to do that, so.
At the end of the day, Amy, we're going to pay less than this, and we pay an attorney fee, so we should be good.
Okay, so we're not changing anything in nine, we're good? Roman numeral nine, or it is a nine, right, is that a four?
Nine, it's Roman numeral four.
That's a four, sorry. My eyes are failing me, sorry. Release of claims, what about that one? Any changes to that? Any firms by submitting proposal?
No.
Okay. Cost of proposals, interested firms by submitting proposals agree to bear all costs incurred related submission of the proposal. Seven, interested firms by submitting proposal agree the proposal will be irrevocable through what day?
Well, it looks like we did that 2 weeks after the meeting dates last time, so maybe same idea, 2 weeks after the meeting date?
By submitting proposals, agree their proposals will be irrevocable through.
So they can't.
The 31st, if they're here for an interview,
right?
Then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They can't
decide.
It would
be August 31st.
So if they're here for an interview, they can't decide they hate us and go home.
No.
Well, they can't charge us more.
They can't change their proposals.
But they can't change their costs or anything
right.
like that.
Yeah, they
can
do
still
anything.
Pay for it.
No, I think you guys are going to be a lot more difficult. We're doubling it.
But Jeff,
yo.
Back to page 6 under acceptance of proposal. Last time there were 2 days, September 5 and 12, 2011.
Right.
And then when you go back to the page 7 for the Roman numeral 7, it gave 2 days after that last meeting date. That's why I was suggesting maybe we do the same thing. 2 weeks after that, the date that we meet with them. So if we meet with them on the 31st, give them the middle of September.
So here's the thing, if we decide on somebody on the 31st, we vote on
them. Oh, well, it's a done deal, yes.
Yeah.
Then,
right.
Okay, what am I putting in here? August 31st, or am I going to put in our board meeting date of September 6th? What do I want to put in here?
I
August
say
31st?
Put the 31st.
Okay.
Put the 31st.
All right. August 31st, 2000. Questions and clarifications? No person employed by another organization.
Oh, yeah, I have something there.
Yeah.
I think that. The second paragraph, questions and requests for clarification must be submitted to the Board of Education president in writing. We have to tell them who to contact if they have a question.
Right.
Okay.
And I think it needs to come to you.
Great.
Come to you.
Excellent.
And then the next sentence is the Board of Education president may respond to written questions and requests for clarification in writing. And copies will be provided to the members of the board so we know what kind of questions are coming
right.
in. So you're going to be the point person to get the questions.
Okay.
And then you let us know what you decided to do. You're not going to have, you know, what's going to happen is they may call you and say, I can't make the August 31st.
Sure.
And so then that's the kind of question, you're
okay.
not going to get too many questions from it.
Are we going to have copies will be posted on the district website?
I don't know why.
No, provide to the board members.
It's just to
just
board.
Email to
Does
the board
RFP
members.
Does the RFP have to be public though? Does the responses don't have to be public?
No.
No.
We just have to keep track of
we
it.
Just
right.
have to keep track.
Okay, in case there are questions.
So
we're going to take that out. How are we going to change it?
So all we're going to do is put the Board of Education president
yep.
may respond to written questions and requests for clarification in writing. And notify other board members. I don't know.
Copies
the board
members.
And copies provided
to all board members.
To the all board members. Yeah.
Questions of the copies of the questions, right?
Copies.
And
copies
written response.
Right.
Well, that was what I was going to ask you. So then, are we just saying that the board president is going to get the questions and respond, and then just give us copies?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So he'll just copy us on.
No, and my question is, we're not having any input on whatever the other questions are.
He needs to be the contact with the search.
No, I get that. He's the contact.
If it's a question he can't answer, I'm sure he's going to send out an email
to us. And then he's going to find out.
I can't make any decisions.
Respond.
I mean, if it's a question, I mean, I can give an answer. But I mean, I can't change the RFP like this says. I have no authority to modify the RFP, but if they call me and say I have a question, what time do I have to be at the meeting? I have the ability to respond to say that the meeting...
Well, that's a simple one. I'm not talking about something that simple. I'm just saying if there's a...
If it rises to a level where it needs board action, I mean, whatever you want to do.
I'm not even sure I'm saying that it requires board action as much as I'm saying... Should not the whole board, if there's a question or request for clarification...
We don't want the search firm contacting all seven board members.
No, I'm not saying that. When I'm sitting here, let's try this again. Jeff is the board president. Everything's coming through him. What we're saying right now is there's a question or clarification. It comes to Jeff. He does the answer or the clarification. And he lets us know after the fact. What I'm asking is, should he let us know before the fact?
When I get a question...
No, because now you're into that violation of the Open Meetings Act. If he puts out a question to all of...
No, they're asking him. He's just letting us know, so we're violating Open Meetings if we do that. Okay.
Yeah, if he puts it out and says
but
what...
But this is an RFP, so it's still the same thing?
He cannot put anything out. He could call us, I guess. You could call us individually if you want to make six other phone calls, but he can't put anything out through email asking us for our opinion because you violated the Open Meetings
Act. I'm not necessarily saying do it through an email. I'm just saying contact us. Do we need to...
It's also called round robin. It's also illegal.
No, I'm not asking for that. What I'm saying is are we putting everything into the hands of the board president, no matter what comes in, writing a clarification? It's all in his hands alone without anything from the board. Like, I don't even know what kind of questions or clarifications might be coming through. I mean, this might just actually be a moot point. But all I'm asking is... If that happens, is it normal in an RFP such as this for him to be the sole person that answers the question and then obligates the board to something we don't know about until after the fact?
I feel pretty comfortable that he's not going to obligate us to anything and that he will go ahead and answer a question if it's a reasonable question. Yeah. And if it's something bigger, I feel pretty confident that he'll come to us.
Okay, how about this, Sharon? How about this? How about I add the Board of Education president may respond after notifying the board to written questions?
You got to be careful, though.
No, I don't mind the way you've got it done. I just had this little question, and I'm not saying
no, I get it.
You can't, what you can't do is like...
Yeah, you can't run around for sure.
No, and you can't put something out to the board. I got a question from ABC firm, and they want to know blah, 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 blah. What do you think?
Yeah.
You cannot do that.
Okay.
Because you violated open meetings. You cannot put anything out where you want a decision coming in from the board. So
unless
I think we
this.
Just need to trust our board president to... I don't think there's going to be anything. There's not going to be anything. There might be. I can't make August 31st. Would there be another date?
Right.
Then what he could say we can do that, and then at a meeting you can bring that up and say, I told him we're going to have another meeting. Check your calendars. Let's do a special meeting.
I'm good with that, but I have another question backing up real quick. Interested firms by submitting proposals, the proposal will be irrevocable through 8/31. Now, I know, Mary, you said if we decide to do something on the 31st, we're good to go. But what if you decide not to? Does that mean that they could then say, oh, you said we couldn't do anything to them through the 31st, but that you haven't decided on when we can change something different?
No, it means they can't change their price to us after the 31st. If we choose not to go with them, then we choose not to go with them. If we want to add to it, we can certainly add to it for a different cost later.
Right, right.
If we choose to take away from it, then of course that's something we'd have to talk with them about when we're in the interview. Do you have an a la carte kind of thing?
Okay. I think I just wanted to make sure that we were protecting ourselves from someone changing it. It just sort of felt like by putting a date in, which is the date we're meeting with them, it left an opportunity for them to do that. Does it make sense to anybody?
The people that will be opening the bids cannot divulge what those costs came in at, because you don't want that information to get out and then all of a sudden have them come back and say, oh, I'm going to change my proposal. Here, we made a typo.
Yeah, I think I was just hanging on the fact that in the prior time you guys had given them 2 weeks after the last meeting, and I think it was just something in my head, kind of like you gave them 2 weeks after the last meeting, there must have been a reason why that was done. And
no,
I was just trying to figure it out.
It might have just been the timeline, and we don't really need 2 weeks.
Okay, that's good.
Especially since we're hiring an interim also.
Okay.
This timeline needs to be
right, we're going to work on that.
Yeah.
And I hope maybe is someone is writing down the changes too, right? I'm doing it on computer.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, okay.
We got it.
If you know how savvy I am on computer.
Too late now.
All right, excellent. They're on the same page. All right, timeline. At this time, the board intends to complete the process of recruiting and hiring a new superintendent. Finally, timeline, which the board reserves the right to modify. Publication of RFP. Now, this is for the hiring of a superintendent, right?
No, the RFP. That's
no,
for
this,
the search firm.
Okay, this is for the search firm.
Yeah, right. Not the superintendent.
So if it goes out...
No, this says new superintendent. Because I saw something early in here, which this proposal has to outline for the firm,
right,
our timeline for hiring a superintendent.
Right, but you can't hire until you get a firm to do this stuff.
So just change it. Hiring an interim superintendent and a new superintendent.
Right, yeah. Okay. At this time, the board intends to complete the process of recruiting and hiring a...
interim superintendent.
All right.
You're going to be able to type that word really good.
Yeah.
Muscle memory.
Okay. And new superintendent, according to the following timeline, which the board reserves the right to modify. The publication of RFP.
That one is August 2nd, 2016, right?
We approve it on August 1st, right?
We're going to approve it the 1st.
Yep.
Should we give...
Why don't you give it to the 3rd?
To the 3rd. I'm thinking that too. That's kind of...
Okay.
And we need to change it in the
part 2. Okay, hold on.
It's going to be published.
That was the question I was asking. How long between the two?
This is the timeline for us to have the firm put out the RFP for interim...
That's us.
This is our
publication.
The publication of the RFP is us.
It says response to the RFP.
The RFP is to get the firm to do the search. So we do the RFP to get the firm.
And then
when you move down further is where you're
going
to
check
what you're talking about.
Then the next one is August 19th, 16.
Okay. All right, so hold on. I'm sorry, I have to go back. So the publication of RFP, August what?
3rd, 2016.
Okay.
Okay. Deadline for interested firms to respond to RFP?
August 19th.
4 p.m.
Friday.
Do I have to put, should I put the 4 p.m.?
Yeah, as well.
Mm-hmm.
August 19th, 2014.
Yeah.
16.
See, you're paying attention. Okay.
Are these tricks?
To RFP, August 19th, 2016, 4 p.m. by 4 p.m.
I think Amy's correct. We probably should do EST.
Yeah, EST.
We should. I don't know. Where we've got a time thing. Because we're assuming.
Yeah, because 4 p.m. in Washington is the
right.
A couple of those are in Illinois, too.
And that's an hour after
us. Just saying.
All right.
Depending on if we've sprung forward or fallen behind, right?
All right, let me just make sure I got this.
Okay, interviews qualified for...
And if they're smart, they're going to send them by FedEx or one of those that require assigned delivery.
Yep.
Okay, a deadline for interested firms to respond to RFP by 4 p.m. EDT, August 19, 2016. Okay. Board of Education interviews of qualified interested firms. Special meeting of Board of Education week of...
No date.
August 31, 2016.
6:30 p.m.
August 31, 2016.
EST.
Do we put the time?
Yep.
6:30.
Yep.
Okay.
So I think for the next one, we should put the Board of Education selects the firm at a special meeting of Board of Education no later than September 6th, 2016.
Okay, the Board of Education selects firm, special, not special meeting. Do we want to do a special meeting or do a board meeting?
Well, it can be a special meeting or a regular meeting.
Just take special out.
Just take special.
Yeah.
Meeting of Board of Education week of...
Data. We could say no later than September 6th, because that's our next board meeting after that.
No later than.
So it requires us to have a decision made.
No later than
September
6/2016, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Submission of candidates for Board of Education interviews.
Now, this is where you got to
divide this is, but we put that in there last time, and this is not the timeline that was followed. So this is, I don't even know if you want to go there.
Delete it?
Because...
Do we develop the timeline with the firm then?
So we're going to have two separate timelines for this because we will have an interim and a superintendent search. And probably that's a timeline that we should allow them to develop. Or at least to develop with them.
The board will work with the company.
Selected firm.
Selected firm.
Like this was just like mid-October. That wasn't specific.
Yeah.
So submission of candidates for... Interim,
we had no idea how long it would take Lee to do all the work that he did and develop
and so that's
the stuff
why you
that he
say
did.
You get really
so you might just want to even leave it out that the board will work with selected firm to develop a timeline for the selection of interim and the selection of new superintendent.
Yeah, that kind of like,
yeah, because you just don't know.
Right.
Right, so I'm deleting the next three bullet points, correct?
Yeah.
Well, you're deleting and then just adding the board will work with.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm getting rid of all these, correct?
Right.
Yes.
Right. Okay, and I'm adding what now?
You say Board of Education
will work with the selected firm
to establish
to develop a timeline for the hiring of an interim supervisor and supervisor, final candidate supervisor.
The Board of Education will work with the selected firm to develop a timeline to interview and select.
Interview and select.
An interim
superintendent?
Interim
supervisor and
interim
the
superintendent
final.
And a new superintendent.
And the new superintendent.
Okay. Jeff, you got all that? You're shorthand up
to
speed?
Hold on now.
Your secretary of schools are still.
Okay.
Okay. Board of Education will work with the selected firm to develop a timeline to interview and select an interim superintendent and new superintendent.
Right, perfect.
That's it.
Okay.
Is that it? That's it. All right, so for me, my work is I need to contact the superintendent tomorrow and get clarification on these facilities and also the graduation rate, the transportation, check on staff, just make sure that the district information is basically correct along with the facilities information. And then,
right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. So one last item.
Okay.
We are running into an issue. Our superintendent has a 3-year contract. If we do not have a resignation letter, retirement letter before September 2nd, her contract will roll over.
It's October 2nd, 90 days.
It's October 2nd?
Right. It's 90 days.
90
but
days.
She doesn't get 90 days because she's not tenured in the state of Michigan. There are different tenure laws. So regardless of if she fails to provide a separation letter for retirement or whatever reason before then, she can be terminated at any time because she's not tenured in the state of Michigan.
And she's already announced, but you know,
we still need a formal letter.
But
formal letter.
Before this is started, I mean, we do need a letter.
But her contract says 90 days, so how do you do that differently if she, the state with her tenure?
My concern is
so.
That if it rolls over, I mean, we're talking about $900,000 of compensation we will owe her.
Then she needs to provide a letter.
So
I think if the board would feel safer than that, then there needs to be a letter provided before October 2nd saying that she's separating from the district.
Well, what I'm saying is...
It should probably be done before this even goes out.
I think we need to put forth a timeline, a very specific timeline, because I understand Jackie's hesitant to give us a letter, and that's fine. But in order for us to move forward as a district, we need to be able to move forward completely. And that means we either issue a non-renewal or we have a retirement letter. I think this board needs to put together an actual timeline, say, if by this date we do not have a retirement letter, then we need to issue a non-renewal.
I think we talked about this already, and I don't think it's an issue to just get the separation letter.
I understand you think trust is a good thing.
It may be an issue.
And I'm all about some trust occasionally.
It may be an issue once we look at firms and start hiring them. They're going to want to know.
They'll want to see that.
They're not going to want to go through a process, start a process if we haven't received.
No, I appreciate that, but I think I'm having a problem with the fact that we've got some who look at the contract that says December 31st. As you said, it's out there publicly, it's out there in writing, it's on some of our minutes.
Not in any writing.
December 31st, yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
Okay.
Anyway, I guess I'm confused about the 90-day thing and her not being tenured by the state of Michigan. What exactly does that mean? What's the 90-day?
90-day is in her contract.
That's what I'm saying. It's a 90-day thing in her contract. So what is?
So if we're going to go by that, well, she can be let go at any time.
Sure.
Because she's non-tenured in the state of Michigan. She's not covered by the tenure laws. So, but
how does, that's what I'm saying, is how does it affect the 90 days?
But if the 90
days
is in her contract, then yes, we should have something from her. But
absolutely.
But any firm is going to probably want us to have that before they even come in and start working with us. Why would they want to get involved with us, start down the road of some process, and then we have some other sticky issue hanging out there? They don't know.
Okay, so here's what I, and maybe it's a legal question, because if we're to get a letter of intent to separate, I guess is that binding?
Not a letter of intent. It has to be an actual letter of separation.
Okay, but if she sends a letter of separation to say that she's separating on this date, right?
December 31.
No, she'd be just separating on this date. She's not obligated to do that because her contract states she has to give 90 days notice prior to separation.
No, we have to give her 90 days or her contract rolls over. Her contract is a 3-year contract with a almost $300,000
right.
a year compensation. If we terminate her, the total compensation package.
No.
So if we allow her contract to roll over, then there's a good likelihood that she gets her compensation for 3 years.
No.
We're out on
$1 million. We have the copy of the contract. I don't remember reading it like that at all. Mary had said that she has to, within 90 days of when she wants to retire, she has to give the board notification.
So I guess I don't understand.
Okay, so maybe it's a legal. I guess it's a legal question because I hear what you're saying.
But
it's a legal question because I don't know if she.
You got to look at her contract, Jeff.
I got her contract.
No, hold on. It may be a legal question about what we can do as a board. It's this is a legal question that I see. Because,
so you look at the contract.
Well, hold on, Sherry. Okay, because. I don't know what she can give us other than her letter of resigning prior to her 90 days. She doesn't have to do that.
She does need to give us. Okay, if we're moving forward with this,
yes.
Then I think we need to have an absolute timeline because we cannot allow her contract to roll over.
Correct.
So, okay, we can't put ourselves in that boat.
Correct.
And if she truly is planning on retiring, giving us a retirement letter or separation letter should not be an issue. So I suggest that we have a specific timeline. If by September 20th we do not have a retirement letter or a separation letter, then we need to issue the notice of non-renewal.
I don't agree with that at all.
Well,
she doesn't give it to you by October 2nd. You have to do it by October 2nd. If
right,
you're going to abide by
what
the
I'm
90
saying
days,
is,
there has to be a letter issued. Either she
right.
gives us a letter stating her
right.
intent to retire, or we're
right.
giving her a letter saying
right.
and you're
and
not coming back.
Right. What I'm saying is we're preemptively saying, we don't think she's going to do that, so we're going to do this instead.
But she hasn't done it
you
yet.
Have to.
That's the problem.
Legally,
we're
you have to cover your rear end.
I'm not saying we don't. What I'm saying is she's got a contract that says ABC.
Correct.
And so what is
entering into a contract with a firm before that date?
I think a lot of firms have probably entered into contracts with districts. Probably
yeah,
the same situation.
I don't quite think it would be an issue with that.
There would be some guidance there from
what
a.
What is the contract,
The contract says it's paragraph 20 resignation, and I'm quoting what the contract says: the superintendent shall provide the Board of Education with at least 90 days written notice prior to terminating this contract.
So we would need by October 2nd, and the same 90 days applies. If we don't issue the letter of non-renewal, then the three-year contract rolls over, which we cannot afford.
No,
I agree. So we will make sure that that doesn't happen.
So I think we need to give her a timeframe.
We can't though, that's what I said.
She has a timeframe in her contract.
We can't force her to give us anything prior to the 90 days.
But you can let her know that if you don't receive something on October 1st, she's getting a letter of non-renewal.
Okay.
She gets that.
Period.
Okay, well, we can do that. I mean,
you can formally let her know that.
So at the meeting on September 19th, we can tell her that if we don't have this letter by the 1st of October, we will be issuing a letter and make it formal at the board meeting.
She knows what she has to do.
I understand that, but it needs to be clear, and we need to cover ourselves so that it's clear. Saying she knows is one thing. Saying she was properly notified is completely different.
You don't want it ever to wind up in court and say, I was never properly notified.
I think it's amazing that we all think that someone that has done what she's done for as long as she's done doesn't understand her own contract. I get covering ourselves. I'm not talking about that. I don't think we have an issue here at all. And I think constantly repeating we need to give her a letter of non-renewal is ridiculous. We don't need to do that.
I don't want to have to do that.
I don't want to have to do that to anybody.
No, but we need to be prepared to do it.
Oh, if we have to, we will, but I don't think we're going to have to.
That's fine, but we need to be prepared as a board to do that.
Okay, so we understand. We need a letter of resignation from her by, it's 90 days. I haven't counted back 90 days. So 90 days back from December 31st, we figure out what that is. And we need to have it by then.
I don't understand the waiting game.
I don't understand what we're making.
Because there's no game. Legally, you can't ask her or make her do it before then.
No,
you can't.
She's complying with her contract.
You're missing what I'm saying. She has said, she told Linda when she asked for the contract extension, she plans to retire. I don't understand why she didn't submit that at that time. I don't understand why she hasn't submitted it at any other time that she's been asked about it. I don't understand why we're waiting if it's truly our intention.
I don't know.
She's made the statement at a board meeting.
She has not made a statement at a board meeting. We expect that Jeff has said that he's had conversation with her.
Excuse me. Right. And doesn't see it as a problem. I don't foresee it being a problem. I don't know that we want to get into a legal battle with somebody. If we want to start jumping into that, we could be. Right.
It won't be legal, but Mary is right in a way that we have to protect the fact that we're right. We want to make sure that we are protected, that to say that, hey, when it comes time, 90 days, we're going to either need a letter of resignation or you will be...
And we've already done this at the board table. This isn't new. We keep doing this every time we get
together. But it's not been done formally.
Okay, well, we need to figure out, like Linda
said,
what...
October 2nd is her 90-day thing. Okay. So if you want it by September, you're asking us to make her do something her contract does not require.
She just needs to be notified that it needs to be done by whatever date. We need to put it on the record formally
at a meeting to say by October 2nd, because we're going through this RFP process for the superintendent, so we need by October 2nd. The superintendent's letter of resignation.
I don't have a problem
with
that. I have a problem
point
with
blank.
September.
That's it. We cannot make a decision here. First of all, we're not operating in a full board function.
Right.
We cannot make a determination for the board on an action that we would take against the superintendent.
Right.
We simply can't do that at this meeting.
So that's a public discussion.
Right. So I have a quick question.
Yeah.
A letter of non-renewal, would that need to be signed by every member of the board?
A letter of non-renewal, I don't know.
Yes.
It's basically saying we're firing you.
That would have
saying
to be a board
we're
action.
Not renewing your contract.
Yeah,
after
but a lot
December
of times a non-renewal is a firing. Basically, we're not renewing your contract. You're no longer working here.
We non-renewed Ed's contract because we didn't need the position anymore.
Okay. But we non-renewed
non-renew
a lot of
contracts
those
all the time.
Jobs. But whatever.
Okay.
So there's no problem with. I'm not having a problem with saying we need to do this. I'm having a problem with violating what's in her contract, and I'm having a problem doing it in September. It is not required.
It won't be.
It'll be done in October on the date that it's supposed to be done. We'll just put it on the record.
That's fine.
Okay.
I don't have a problem with that.
Put what on the record?
We'll put it on the record that...
when we discuss it at the board table.
We'll discuss it at the board table. What the 90-day date is that the notice has to be given by.
And I expect you'll have a conversation with her regarding the timeframe.
Yeah, and I've talked to her before, and she was frank about it. She said, I have in my contract 90 days, and I will give 90 days when that time comes. And I said, okay, I get it.
Can you find out if a notice of non-renewal needs to be signed by every board member? Just because, again, that does...
I don't know who I'd ask.
Besides the contract.
I don't know who I'd ask. I'm not going to call the attorney about it.
Besides your contract.
I don't know who I'd ask.
HR should know.
HR?
Right.
Me and you signed it the last time.
Just because we are, collectively, we are responsible for hiring her, and I don't know if that's something that can just be signed by one person.
It cannot be signed by one
person. That is too much power of one person. I can't imagine how that would be okay.
Yeah, imagine being a board action.
It has to be a board action.
I'm an hour over my timeframe for the hour.
You're fine.
I got a dog, I got my child.
Actually, it was good.
Who's that, who's really savvy with computers? Because I want to make sure I save this properly.
That's a Mac. I don't know anything about Macs.
I don't know what's...
That'd be Amy.
All right.
Sorry.
No, unfortunately, I don't have
Word.
We need a motion to adjourn 8:30, right? Do we need a motion to adjourn or no?
Some move.
Linda and Pam. It's numbers.
Linda, this is your time.